Don't mess around, you scammer. If you didn't have any savings, I wouldn't have married you. I was planning to spend my life leeching off your money. Damn it. I never expected my husband to be such a despicable man. I had reached my limit with my husband, who kept insulting me. And then, I came up with a forbidden revenge.
This can't be true.
As I looked down on my astonished husband, I smirked. My name is Aaliyah, a 34-year-old office worker. I've been working for a company since graduating from college, for over 12 years now. Although I had been devoted to my work and had been given a decent position in the company, I was far behind in my private life. Many of my friends were getting married and having children, and my parents were starting to ask me when I was going to get married. I had lived for myself until now, thinking that I would be happy as long as I was devoted to my work. But when my parents said they wanted to see me in a wedding dress, and my friends said that marriage was a good thing, and my heart began waver. According to my friends, marriage is also about making your family happy, not just yourself, and it can be done while working hard at your job. After hearing that, I became interested in marriage. However, I knew that the partner I choose is the key. I wanted someone who understand my devotion to work and was someone I could chill around. Although looks and income from work are somewhat important, I didn't place too much emphasis on income because I could earn my own money. With that in mind, I began looking for someone to date with the intention of getting married. Then a friend told me they would host a mixer, so I decided to participate. I was nervous at my first mixer, but it turned out to be a normal drinking party atmosphere, and I felt relieved. The men who participated in the mixer were all classmates from university who have decent jobs. Among them, I talked a lot with a guy named Bill. Bill was 1 year older than me, and because we were close in age, we had a lot of common topics to talk about. He had a good sense of humor. It was fun to talk to him. At my first mixer, I felt like I had found a good person. But at that time, a woman named Cindy came between us.
Hey Bill, having fun? Aaliyah, is it? Can you please give up your seat? I want to talk to Bill.
Huh? Oh, sure. Go ahead.
Overwhelmed by her aggressiveness, I gave up my seat, and Cindy stayed with Bill the whole time.
At this rate, there is no way Bill and I will get any closer.
Thinking that, I gave up on the mixer and decided to focus on my meal. Cindy is much younger and cuter, and she's probably better for Bill anyway. The other men had already paired off with other women, so I waited for the mixer to end, feeling a little bitter. But after the mixer ended, Bill asked me for my contact information outside the store.
I didn't get to talk to you much, Aaliyah, so how about we meet up and chat at a cafe sometime?
I was surprised, but very happy. And for the first time in a while, I felt like I remembered what it was like to be in love. From then on, I exchanged messages with Bill and met him at a cafe on our days off. We talked a lot, and I thought we were really compatible. Being with him just felt so comfortable. I'm not the type to be aggressive, and I think I've been pretty cautious in my few past romantic experiences. But with him, I thought I could marry him. We continued to deepen our relationship naturally, but we weren't officially dating yet. Then, Cindy suddenly contacted me. Cindy was a junior of a friend of mine
and we had exchanged contact information before the mixer.
She was like a little demon, with a completely different personality in front of men than in front of women. She had seemed selfish even when we first met, and it seemed like she had her sights set on Bill. So she must have seen me as her enemy.
What's this about, Cindy?
Cindy said she wanted to meet me and talk to me after work. So I agreed with some caution.
Can I ask you straight up? You don't think you were going to date Bill, do you?
I do want to date him.
You're really out of your league, aren't you, Aaliyah?
Huh? What do you mean?
I know you're aware of this,
but I'm also after Bill.
Yeah, I figured as much.
There is no way I'm not going to win, right? I'm younger and cuter than you.
And you are already an old lady.
You. Do you really think I'll fall for such a cheap provocation?
Being young isn't the only positive factor, you know.
Actually, I have a lot in common with him. Don't you have a huge generation gap and struggle to hold a conversation?
Aaliyah, are you trying to compete with me?
Don't you think that just because you are young, you can have everything your way?
Cindy and I were in a confrontational state, ready to fight each other. I think we both had pretty scary faces. But I can't afford to lose to such a young girl. I seem to be more competitive than I thought. As it was my first romance in a while, I consulted with a friend who had invited me to the mixer, thinking that she might suggest something that would help me, as she was also Cindy's senior.
Cindy likes to take away boys that others are interested in, like that.
My friend's frankness surprised me a little. Is she really such a bad person?
Well, that's why I didn't want to bring her to the mixer. But she found out accidentally. If you're going to fight Cindy, it's better not to lose your pace. Just be yourself as usual, and you'll be fine.
Okay, got it. Thanks. If my friend said so, I should follow her advice. So I didn't try to be too aggressive and continued to interact with Bill as usual.
Then one day, Bill confessed his feelings to me.
Can you date me with marriage in mind?
What? Me? Are you okay with me?
Huh? What do you mean okay with you?
Oh, never mind.
So, what's your answer?
Yes, of course.
Great. Thank you, Aaliyah.
And so, I started dating Bill. That meant I had won against Cindy. I was happy that I could be with the person I liked and that I had won against her. Cindy didn't contact me in particular, but according to my friends, she was quite upset. After that, Bill and I continued our relationship smoothly, and about 6 months later, he proposed to me. For the first time in my life, I tasted the pinnacle of happiness. Even though I was always busy with work, it was great to be proposed to. My parents also liked him, and I liked his parents as well. We had a face-to-face meeting with both families, and we were able to have a successful wedding. My friends and co-workers also celebrated my wedding grandly, and I was very happy. After that, we started our married life.
Welcome home, Aaliyah.
I'm home, Bill.
Oh, something smells good.
Today, it's herb grilled chicken.
Yummy. Thanks, babe.
My husband comes home earlier than I do and takes the initiative to do household chores. He always cooks dinner for me when I come home, so it really helps. It seems like we could continue to have a happy married life together. But that kind of happiness only lasted for the first few months. After that, our relationship
deteriorated rapidly.
And it all started when my husband asked me something.
By the way, how much do you have in savings, Aaliyah?
Savings? Why do you ask?
Well, I was thinking that as a couple. It's good to know each other's savings, you know? To have an idea of how much we need to save for something like a future home.
I see, that does make sense.
So, how much do you have saved up?
I have about $30,000 saved up right now, I think.
Huh? $30,000?
When I answered his question about my savings, my husband's eyes widened and his mouth dropped open.
What? What's wrong, Bill?
No, nothing. Is that your entire savings?
Yeah, that's how much I have right now.
My husband let out a sigh and said he was going to take a bath before walking away from the conversation. I was left wondering what was going on. From his reaction, I could tell that he was upset that my savings were less than he had anticipated. I was angry that he would be so openly upset about my savings being low. I still didn't know how much he had saved up.
The next day, my husband began acting very cold towards me. He would ignore me when I greeted him in the morning and would only prepare dinner for himself, even if he came home earlier than me. I couldn't help but feel angry that he would act this way towards me. But in the midst of all this, something unexpected happened. About 2 weeks after my husband started giving me the cold shoulder, I started feeling extremely sick and left work early to go to the hospital. There, I found out that I was pregnant. I was shocked but overjoyed that I was carrying a life inside of me. I thought that my husband's behavior would change once he found out we were having a baby. I'm pregnant. Upon returning home, I immediately told my husband. He had a startled expression on his face and looked serious.
You're planning to having a child, even though we have no savings?
Of course I am. Are you seriously suggesting I get an abortion?
If we have no money, we may have to consider that option. Besides, your salary won't be fully paid during maternity leave. And expenses will increase when the child is born, right?
Are you serious? I can't believe you made such a statement.
I couldn't believe my husband said something like that.
Unbelievable. Don't you have any empathy? I never thought you were that kind of person.
I became emotional and raised my voice. Then, my husband became angry.
Don't play dumb, you scammer.
What? Scammer?
If you had no savings, I wouldn't have married you. I was planning to spend my life leeching off your money. Damn it. You work for a big corporation, right? Your salary is definitely higher than mine. Yet, you have no savings. That's why you are a scammer. Got it?
I couldn't believe it.
I never imagined that my husband was such a despicable person.
Let's get a divorce then.
No, I won't.
What? Why not? I never said we should break up.
What do you mean?
Even when I asked, my husband just shrugged and didn't give me a reason. After that, my husband started to say terrible things to me.
What's the point of having a child if you are a spendthrift? It's impossible not to save money while working for a big corporation. Marriage to a woman with no savings is a failure.
Every time we met, my husband said such things. If he was so unhappy, he could have just left me. But for some reason, he didn't want to separate.
I don't mind fighting in court for however many years it takes. But if it comes to that, won't it be tough to pay for court fees when we have a child? In that case, it's probably better to continue our married life as it is.
When I heard my husband say that, I realized something. He was probably trying to mentally wear me down so that I would eventually agree to give up child support and property division voluntarily. I absolutely did not want to do that. But continuing to live with my husband was also difficult. I had reached my limit with his constant verbal abuse. Then I thought of a forbidden revenge plan. About 3 months later, one day, I brought up divorce to my husband as usual. However, what was different this time was that I had a secret weapon that could allow me to get a divorce while placing the blame on him. So, you were having an affair. Let's get a divorce.
What did you say?
My husband was speechless as he looked at the evidence I had spread out on the table. You'll be paying a lot in compensation. So, be prepared.
How did you find out?
Bad things always get found out. Just admit your wrongdoing quietly. Anyway, let's handle everything through lawyers from now on. I left my husband, who was frozen with a pale face, and packed my bags while giving him a side glance. Then, I received compensation and requested child support. It seems that my ex-husband was reluctant to pay, but my lawyer pursued the request. Thanks to that, I was able to receive full payment in installments. After that, I took maternity leave and gave birth in my hometown. I gave birth to a healthy baby girl. My parents were very happy to meet their grandchild. My ex-husband apparently planned to remarry his affair partner, but for some reason, he was immediately rejected. I received a message from my ex-husband saying that he wanted to get back together, but I laughed while looking at the message with a certain person. The person was Cindy, who had once competed for my ex-husband's girlfriend position. Actually, I contacted Cindy as revenge against my ex-husband. I told her all about my ex-husband's true nature and asked for her cooperation. Surprisingly, Cindy enthusiastically participated in the plan. Actually, my father was a terrible man and was like Bill. He relied on my mother's income and was a freeloader who didn't work. Listening to your story made me angry, as it reminded me of my father. Cindy no longer had an aggressive attitude like before, and understand my story and situation well. Then Cindy seduced Bill and created a fake romantic relationship that was enough to be evidence of their affair. Baby, my grandfather was a big landowner, and he was actually quite wealthy in the local area. Cindy reportedly used that to appeal to Bill. As a result, my ex-husband thought that he could not only live an easy life, but also marry a beautiful young woman. Thanks to that, I was able to gather evidence of their affair and divorce Bill. I can't thank Cindy enough for her cooperation in this forbidden revenge. On the other hand, Cindy also thanked me. I feel like I was able to get revenge on my father through this, you know? It felt really refreshing. Thank you for giving me this opportunity, Alia. After that, we promised each other to find a good partner next time, and we shook hands firmly. Then, I returned to my parents' house and raised my child with their support. I am truly happy that I get to spend time with my daughter every day. By the way, there was a reason why I had little savings at that time. Before I got married to my husband, I had purchased an apartment for real estate investment, and I had paid almost all the money at that time, which is why I had little savings. Currently,
I earn a considerable amount of money from rental income and my job at a large corporation. I plan to save this money carefully for my daughter's future education and my retirement. For now, I want to take good care of my daughter while being grateful to my parents.